Alright, we're on the play. We're gonna keep this hand. One thing that's awkward about his mana base and the Lightning Elixirs is that he plays three basic island, which you want to get quite often because you're casting a bunch of one mana blue cantrips, and you can't cast Elix if you get like a Sacred Foundry or something, and you can also not get a Sacred Foundry with blue to Delta. So I think we'll have to wait for this Lightning Elix, but the rest of this card, the rest of this hand is pretty good. And we have all the necessary pieces. All right, so here we're gonna probe for two life. I could be paying a mana with the island, but the thing is, I probably want to fetch this turn and then get a Steam Vents tapped. If I do draw a one mana card, I'll play my island and cast the said one mana card, but we'll see. All right, so he's got three probes, a Swift Spear, two fetches, and a Becoming Mint, so we're playing against Death Shadow Zoo, most likely. And we're gonna get Steam Vents. He drew Bubble. Which he uses to target himself. Probe. So I'm tempted on turn two to just Metamorphose and Elix this Swift Spear. But since he has a Mishra's Bauble and a bunch of probes, he's likely going to try to get... He's likely going to draw another creature. And Swift Spear is kind of like the last creature I want to kill in his deck. He's got... Also, he didn't fetch before drawing the card with probe, which means the card he saw on top of Bauble was the card he wanted. So leads me to think that he found another creature. Alright, so he does play Swift Spear. We'll see if he decides to play probes. Alright, plays one. The third. I think at this point we're gonna consider keeping the Helix for his face. Three, down to 15, then we're down to 14. Draws off this Bauble. So he has Becoming Mint that we know. He has Blasting Mire that we know, so he probably has his Black Source with that Shadow. I could be casting Thinking Dice, something that he has a hard time dealing with. Could use it to block. If he wants to expand his Becoming Mint to try and kill it, I'm fine with that. So I could Metamorphose an Elix, but then I'm left with a bunch of blanks. And if he has a Death Shadow and another creature, not a great shape. So I think I'll just thing in the ice here. Alright, so we're gonna block one. You can Becoming Mint if you want. Alright, looks like he doesn't do anything. Now, he's likely gonna get an untapped land because he doesn't really play basics. And if I can somehow, like, draw another Metamorphose and a one mana cantrip, a Metamorphose. Could potentially play enough spells. I think we'll start with this. If I can draw any one mana card, I'll be fine. Wait, that's the mana. Okay, that's the mana. I'm paying for it. And we'll be making red, just to cast another one. Alright, so we got it. We'll have to make red white. Helix this guy.
I guess that's not... Okay. This is not in horror. And we'll thought scour him just to not give him information. And swing for lethal. Alright, well, that's cool. We didn't have to do much. Alright, so we definitely want explosives against them. Then the maybes are Blood Moon, Path, and Rest for the Wary. I think Reman is pretty bad, so we're for sure boarding that out. And the other options are... I'm not even sure if Pyromancer Ascension is that good in the matchup. I feel like he's just killing himself. But he might... If he decides to be more careful, I guess we would have too much of a problem to win the game. Visions of Beyond maybe is not the kind of card we want, because we're... He's not going to be trying to grind us, and we don't really need that much card advantage. We just need to survive. So if we board these out, we could board in the Rest for the Wary. And I think Blood Moon is too slow on the draw. On the play, I'll consider it. So these, and I'll board in like one Visions. Because I don't have anything else. Alright, so we're going to be keeping that hand. Keeps a 7 as well. Straight Wraith is fine. Alright, great. So we drew the land we needed. Could be casting Faithless Looting. However, I'm not really looking for anything in particular right now. Just want to get this thing in the ice on a battlefield. I think I should maybe start with Probe. I don't want to get myself too low on life. The reason I want to play Probe is I want to see if he has a Death Shadow or another creature I would like to path. Otherwise, I'm probably just going to path this Swift Spear. Kind of want to keep the Probe for my Thing of the Ice too. So... play Scalding Tarn here. If I have to path, I'll fetch a Sacred Foundry. Otherwise, I'll just get a tapped land, tapped Demons. All right, Growth is fine. I don't think I path for just 4 damage. I still just want to path the Death Shadow if he has it. Alright, so he has a Mandrill. We'll path this. Getting Sacred Foundry. Then I'll Elix or play Thing in the Eyes. If I play Thing in the Ice, I could be punished by Pyromancer and Battle Rage. If I play Elix, I'm sort of punished by Mutagenic Growth, but it's not the end of the world. I think I like better Elix here. Alright, didn't have it. No creature. So we're just going to jam Thing in the Ice. Play Probe. To try and get a land drop. I would think with 3 cards in hand that he just has like a removal for my Thing in the Ice. Probably not path because he would have gotten the Sacred Foundry untapped maybe. We'll see. Alright, so he had 2 lands, so he's flooding in a Battle Rage. Draw a card. It's not a land. Pass. And he concedes. He drew the land. Alright, so we'll play a second match.